Now, first item noon is immortality. I definitely gonna be picking execration dito sa game number 3.
Alright, so, let's medyo have a 50-50 here.
Decision
split tayo.
Na nga.
It's gonna be a big one, ladies and gents. Ready na ba kayo? Kumain na ba kayo? Dahil ito na ang huling laban ng NXP versus execration sa araw na ito.
Yes, yun na nga mga kaibigan. Sino dito ang mag-uuwi ng bragging rights dito sa dalawang team na to? Pero ito na hinihintay nating mga TP at saka mga stickers na pinangako sa atin ni Kuya Zapno. Pero look at here on the mid, ang ganda ng mga pokes nila dito. Kuya Rockart,
oh my God, the pokes are real and that's going to be a very hard lane to fight here. Lalo na ngayon si Eto Max, naka-farsa siya. Hmm? One of the best supports obviously in the game right now with so much range and damage output early on pa lang. So, execution, expect ko na kayang-kaya ng kontrolin yung early game with the help of these two people. Pero syempre, titignan natin kung paano ang pasok ng NXP. Hindi nila papayagang free na buff lang to and guguluhin lang nila. Fate will still get the buff.
Ang galing nung ganong ikot doon ng NXP solid. I mean, trying doon. Pero ito, mukhang maaabutan yata rito. Chak, no, spotting out, trying to... deny the purple buff dito.
Kami naman, sabi nila.
Oo, but Renejay, tama lang din yung dating niya rito. Mukhang masisecure naman dito ni H2O yung kanyang buff.
Yep. Very close to level 4, so I think we will expect a lot of big team fights here. Pero again, what is going to be the setup? Paano kaya yung gagawin ng NXP dito to actually invade? Kasi this is gonna be a difficult jungle to invade. Mm-hmm. Hindi lang magagawa yung mga usual na ginagawa nila, yep, na papasok sa jungle nung walang problema. They actually will have to deal with so much threats mula sa execution dito sa laban na to.
Most likely. Pero siguro gonna be giving the reason why I actually picked for the execution.
Yep.
One thing is Farsa.
Farsa,
I mean, one of the best support heroes talaga, I think, on this meta.
Oh.
Then, number 2 is the Renegade's hero. Kasi, to be honest, sa mga nakikita ko, ang dami kong to be honest, sa totoo lang, pinansin nga ni Propi kanina yun eh. Pero, nagsasabi kasi ako ng totoo. Yun lang gusto ko sabihin.
Yeah.
Si Renegade kasi...
Rob Luna does not lie.
Oo. Lagi ko siya nakikita sa mga offensive type ng heroes. Like yung kanyang Cho, yung kanyang Hellcurt. Pero if you're gonna be giving Renegade a defensive hero, kumbaga may part sa akin na hindi natin na ma-maximize si Renegade.
Nasasayangan ka.
Oo.
Sa pick na yun. And it's a good pick. Pero it's on the wrong
person. Yes. I'm not saying na hindi kayang laruin ni Renegade.
For sure
ang Gato Katcha. But what I'm trying to say is that there are certain heroes na the best talaga para sa kanya. And the draft actually countered somehow yung mga heroes ni Renegade.
Yeah, and that's actually something that you will need to deal with talaga. I mean, if you're on a team, lima lang talaga kayo eh. Like, no choice. Kung kailangan nyo talaga ng isang extra frontline tank, you will need to adapt. And that's something na magandang testing din yan.
Oo.
Magandang testing din yan para sa NXP, no? Na meron silang mga hero na hindi mo usually makita na gamit nila. Pero, if they can pull it off here in the highest level of play dito sa MPL, aba, that's saying something. That means, napaka-multi-talented mo. Napakadami mong pwedeng gawin for your team, which adds more value to you as a player.
Exactly. Exactly. So, totoo doon. I mean, you actually nakuha mo lahat ng mga points doon, Kuya Rockhart. Ang isa pa dito, mga kaibigan, ang laki ng burst potential kasi din ng execution from the of course, nandun yung Cho could be able a very good pick off.
Mm-hmm.
Tapos somehow, of course, the Farsa with the Feathered Air Strike, 'di ba? Parang ang bilis mag-deal ng damage.
Parang may instant minus 1 kayo pag may nahuli si Benny Cutie, parang
yes.
Ganun, no? And the Farsa is something that you need to really look out for. And si Ito Max ba may gamit? Sobrang, it would be a different story siguro kung napunta to sa, kung napunta to sa NXP because Chester is very good on that.
Actually, pero both of them are
both
good
Farsa players.
Both of them are very
good Farsa players. Ang inisip ko lang talaga, yung Kagura pick, how does it deal with the Farsa pick? Diba? Sa early game, obviously, lamang na lamang kasi si Farsa. Pero pag nagkumpul-kumpul na kayo, tapos hindi nyo napansin yung Kagura, doon na nagkakandaleche-leche yung lineup.
Totoo.
So, depende sa sitwasyon. Depende sa posisyon pala, sorry, ni Chester sa magiging laban sa mid-game. Pero again, medyo mid-game pa yun para sa akin.
Ang problema kasi sa sa isang Kagura is that he actually needs a little bit of time compared sa isang Farsa. I mean, Farsa, kailangan lang niyang mag-level 4 and that's it. Oo. I mean, kahit arcane...
Kahit no items pa, no?
Oo, kahit arcane boots lang. Any boots, to be honest. Kayang-kaya niyang i-mag-deal ng enough damage. But that's a different for ano for Akaguras. Ang difference lang nila probably is yung mechanics nila sa mga team fights, which is after ng Feather Airstrike, eh, mas malaki na yung maibibigay ng isang Kagura. But will they be able to have that time para magkaroon ng item din si Chester?
Yun ang kailangan nating tignan. Mm-hmm. And nagiging solid, nagiging klaro na kung ano yung mga win condition ng ating mga manlalaro dito ngayon.
Yes, yun na nga. Pero still, medyo ano pa, medyo nagiging cautious sila dito. This is not what we've seen on the first two matches nila. And I think ang unang sagupaan natin dito paglabas pa ng first turtle eh.
Yeah, for sure, the first turtle is going to be the biggest deal. Lalo na si H2O. Matang-mata niya yan. Like, if he does not get the turtle early on, that's gonna be a problem. But looks like it's gonna be a team fight here sa mid lane. Mga kaibigan, si Hate na nadalas yata dito.
Oh,
with H2O picking up the first blood. I think he wanted to dive
totoo.
Further.
Ang maganda kasi doon, ano, Uya Ra, ang ganda ng pwesto
ganda
din doon ni Rainy J. Naka-ready yung ano niya doon, yung... tawag dito, yung pag-taunt niya doon. Tapos naipit sila, even with the Jit Kundo doon. Pero... wow, what a very time he played on for ano. Pero dito tumalon si Yawi not being hitting with Benny Cutie and ang daming TP kong nakita doon.
Yep, that's a lot of TPs and Benny Cutie showing na napaka-confident niya. Kayang-kaya mag-survive there on the bottom lane. Pero ngayon, turtle in 10 seconds, ano ang magiging reaction ng execration dito?
Yes, but still, they're still waiting na mag-level 4 dito. Ito yung ano eh, no? Yung timing minsan pagka sa purple buff, pag kinuha mo siya agad, sumasakto siya sa labas din ng turtle.
Exactly. So, ito na yun. Now that meron ng buff si Hate kahit paano, wala siyang orange pero may blue siya, so kaya niya mag-skill spam ng konti. Hmm. Para maging mas komportable siya dito sa laban, sa ilalim ng turtle. Which is mangyayari na yata in a few moments. Execution, inunahan na agad ang NXP. NXP going in and starting to do the collapse.
Yes, pero wala yata ditong pangpalipad si Eto Max. But the ultimate coming from Yawi will be there just to secure Chester will be taking down that Farsa. One man down for the side of Execration. But ito na kaya, kukunin na kaya nila dito ang turtle ng NXP solid.
Nga ba, sinasabi natin mga kaibigan, now NXP, after one kill lang on ito, Maxi Farsa pa nawala. No more vision and no more damage output. They could do this, pero syempre, dahan-dahan muna. Chak, no? Gahanap ng pwesto, looking for the big fatal leech.
Oh!
Secured by Rene J ang turtle, hindi na magiging H2O.
Ang ganda ng Fatal Links pero hindi enough yung follow-up dahil si Eto Mac, isa lang yung tumama doon sa Feather Airstrike. Raging Sunstorm will be there. Yawi dito, pinapakuluan, pinapainitan dito ni Paling Zapnu. H2O going all in and MB still alive doon sa may bandang likuran ng NXP solid.
Napagandang pasok noon. Of course, we still have a sacrificial lamb here. Yawi going down pero again, turtle on the wrong target. So masakit-sakit
yes.
Si Rene J dito. Akala yata niya, Hellcurt pa siya eh.
Ang maganda sa ginawa doon, ano, Eraut, ng, ano, ng NXP solid,
yes.
Hinold nila si Chakno. Kumbaga, hindi nila pinilit yung Lord. Then, yes, nakakuha ng magandang Fatal Links.
Yep.
Actually, tatlo. Or actually, apat. Pero yun nga lang, hindi umabot doon yung backup dito ng Execration. Still, they could be able to pull off at least killing Yawi on the process and MB medyo nabuhay siya doon. Ang pinakamalaking ano doon is nahuli si Hate.
Yeah, sobrang sayang ni nung engage si Chakno kasi yung follow-up kulang lang din. Tapos nahuli pa nga si Hit.
Yep.
Which is naging napakalaking problema dito para sa Execration. Now, it is going to be NXP barreling down! Beautiful Tyrus Revenge and the Fatal Links para makagante. Pero makakatakas naman ng NXP doon sa engage niya with Rene J with the zone. Grabe! Panigurado?
Grabe. Ito, Kuya Rockert, sobrang MVP ng mga galawan dito ni Yawi. I mean, yes, with the Tyrant's Revenge, don huli niya kagad yung dalawa. At then, as well, Rene J just zoning out with the Avatar of the Guardian, giving an anxiety dito kay Eto Mac. Hindi siya basta-bastang nakapag-feathered airstrike.
That's
kasi,
true.
Kasi, pwedeng-pwede siyang biglang talunan ni Rene J.
And Rene J definitely knew when to go in.
Hmm?
Kailangan nila i-secure yung tower na yun. Kailangan nila ma-secure yung HP din nila H2 kasi napuwersa din sila H2 na mag-tempest of blades para makaiwas sa damage output. And syempre, Avatar the Guardian, great zoning tool. Kahit hindi tumama yan, basta takutin mo lang yung kalaban mo, nagawa mo na yung trabaho mo.
Exactly. Looks like Hate dito, hindi nakakakuha ng the usual place niya sa kanyang Lancelot. Lagi siyang napipick up dito, mga kaibigan. Feather S9, look at Yawi, look at the Avatar of the Guardian from Renny J hitting the far side. Two-man down para sa ilang execration. May fatal links pero hindi enough. Chuck mo dito, mukhang mapanganib, habol na. MB will be taking down the Atlas and that's gonna be a three-man down for execration. May susunod pa nga yata record. That's gonna be Zapnu almost killing everyone from the side of execration. Very cutie. Just getting a consolation tower dito sa bandang ibaba. Mga kaibigan, ang score 1 over 10. Nako po, delikado sa social media ang mga ganitong score.
Nako po, oo, napopost ang mga ganitong score, mga kaibigan. We will have to see if execution kaya ba nilang i-tilt back ang laban na to because that is becoming very difficult for them to win. Lalo na ngayon si H2O, nakuha na yung turtle na dapat sa kanya. They will go for a fight once more on top lane. Ayaw pa magpapigil, ayaw magpawat. NXP, they will have control of this game with a almost 5,000 gold lead.
Oo, grabe. I mean, H2O dito, mga kaibigan, ready in the zone. 504 KDA. Literal dito, Rockhart. Talagang nagsusnowball na rito ang NXP solid as of 7 minutes into the game. They could be potentially na mag-deny na
si
dito. Pero si Hate doon na naman nahuli yung nahuli. Naman.
Same spot.
Ang matindi rito. Kung ano yung score ni H2O, yun naman yung kabaliktaran nung kay Hate.
Baliktad na baliktad. As in, I cannot believe my eyes. Okay, here we go.
Tuloy.
H2O ayaw pa rin mapigil with Chester in danger though with the last insanity. Zapnu, na-take down naman niya ang kanyang karibal. Pero for the meantime, lamang pa rin. On the map, everyone else starting to get in position for a big push.
Totoo yan, mga kaibigan. 4,000 lead pa lang naman dito ang NXP solid. And what's at least there's still gonna be a good juice for execution because they do have here the Forza that could be able to win stand or at least go into the late game. That Way of the Dragon ni Ben QT, pero hindi yata enough. But the Feather Airstrike will be there. Chaknu will be taking down the life dito ni Yawi. And Avatar of the Guardian out for Renny J.
Yep, dahil dun, and of course, they will still get something for that. Ang problema dito, nagiging hit or miss na slowly yung mga engage ni Yawi magiging problema kasi mga pinsan pag sobrang ganda ng momentum mo mapapago
oo kumbaga parang ano eh parang in hit ka eh
oo in hit
oo, gigil na gigil ka so parang you have the momentum you tend to probably commit mistakes kasi nga more on aggression ka going forward pero ito really mukhang triangle defense yung pinapakita rito for Benny Cutie pero isipa kinounter ng Tempest of Blade pero H2O para sa likod eto Max tamang tama yung pasok niya pero ang bilis tumalon sa pader doon ni H2O and still gonna be alive dito sa laban na to.
Grabe yun. Wala akong masabi dun. Natahimik ako. And of course, makuha pa rin ng NXP yung turtle sa top lane habang nangyayari lahat na to. H2O should have died.
Oo.
Pero hindi pa rin talaga.
Isang ano na lang yun eh.
Isang one hit na lang
isang
yun
eh. Isang one hit, isang kiliti. Look at that, mga kaibigan. Yawi dito trying to check on the bushes dito. Mga kaibigan, still, this is an NXP solid. A game to lose para sa kanila. It's up for execution to hold dahil isa na lang or probably yung torrent nila dito ay nauubos ng paunti-unti sa kanilang tier 3 turret na lang halos yung nabubuhay sa kanila aside from the top lane.
That's right. And I think gusto na nating tapusin ng NXP solid yung bottom lane second and yung top lane second. So, this is a lot of gold. Isang katutak na gold pero mahuli ba nila sa H2O? Will be going down there. Yawi with a big engage. Fatal Links mag-isa. Ganong kakamahal. Neto.
Buhay pa din. Kuya Rakhart.
Grabe naman si Boss Yawi. Going down with the last insanity. Pero looks like H2O kuha pa rin ang target sa gusto niya. That's Zapnu once more on this X-board.
Grabe. Still, 4-man down sa execration. Si MB tumambay na sa base dito ng execration. Sabi niya, ako na lang bahala dito, mga tol. It's gonna be Eto Max na lang ang buhay. This could be it.
This could be it, man. A very, very strong finish kung sakali. NXP wants to go in. Tower lock, base lock agad. Pero,
boy ba?
Like Eto Max.
Wala minion wave.
Walang minion wave. Sinakripisyo yung sarili niya para maklear.
Wow. Buti na lang nandoon si Eto Max. Hindi pa tapos yung akalain yung laro dahil nandito pa ang execration. Humihinga pa mga kaibigan.
And it's still going to be a 9K gold lead. A very solid 1-10 and a half minutes. Pero again, hanggat hindi bumabagsak ang base, hindi pa tapos ang labanan. Hate going out of the Phantom Execution. Pero ang problema, bawas niya. Nasaan na? 063 on that Lancelot.
Yes. Ang ano, no, kumbaga parang ang naging play doon ni Chuck, no, sa tara, tanggalin na muna natin sa equation si Yawi. Pero grabe yung kunat doon ni Yawi. Yes, nakahuli. Pero ito, mukhang ang speaking of huli, that's gonna be Chester. Uy. Pero si MB rito, mukhang siya yung susunod. Look at the damage. Ito, Max, dito, medyo nararamdaman na ng NXP solid. Medyo kailangan munang i-hold ng NXP yung kanilang aggression kasi pwedeng-pwede pa din kumambak dito ang execration.
Yep. Malaking bagay yung minus one. And again, kita nyo naman, walang 0606. Mm-hmm. Pag nag-item lock, pag nag-late game, lahat na kayo full items. Kahit yes, ano standing yan, ganun pa rin. So I think yun yung ginagawa, sinusubukan gawin ng execution ngayon. As in, clear mo lang lahat ng minion waves. Hanggang umabot na naman tayo ng 30 minutos dito. At pantay-pantay na naman tayo.
Feeling ko, pinlano ni Ginoong Valdez to eh.
Tingin ko.
Nasabi niya, sige, paano muna natin sa early, tapos comebackin nyo. Then,
yung malaking
sa dulo,
comeback.
Bahala na kayo kung sino makakuha.
Good luck, di ba? Good luck kung mangyayari yun. And, tingnan natin kung maging sagot ni ng ano dito ng NXP is patagalin pa ba natin?
I don't think so ha, kasi Luminous Lord na to, Kuya Rockart.
Big deal na to, and Chakno, all eyes on Chakno dito. Mm-hmm. Kasi ngayon kumpul-kumpul kayo, there's a good chance mahuli kayo if you don't keep your eyes out. Problema, execution. Ang sagot nila, ayaw namin. Hindi kami papatol. Anong akala niyo sa amin? We will wait on the way on the base, and we will try to fight you pag dumating na yung Lord.
Totoo yun. Kasi yung ano din eh, it's gonna be risky for them to be able to dive that one out. Yes, there's a potential na manakaw nila yon, pero at up until what extent, di ba? So
true.
I think they could be able to hold pa rin naman like what we've said. Meron silang Farsa dito that still have an item naman. May Lightning Truncheon na si Etomac dito. Could be able to deal damage. Probably, makuha, I think basag naman na yung top lane talaga nila.
Yes.
So it's gonna be okay. So ang sagot dito for NXP Solid is, kaya ba nila na i-hold yung mga lanes na halos sabay-sabay? Kasi kumbaga yung Lord, hahayaan na nila yan. Eh.
Tama. So, tapos i-flow na lang nila yung mid tsaka yung bot.
Pagsasabayin nila yung gitna saka yung ibaba.
So, ang tanong is, kaya bang mag-depensahan ng execution?
And
ang
I think ito yun,
push.
Ha? Mukhang sakto to. Sakto to. Kaya
here we go, here we go. Sakto, sabay-sabay. Let's go! Will it be a big team fight or will it be a separate fight on top, mid, and bottom? Let's see, Kuya Rob.
Oo, yun na. Tumalon doon si Rene J. Pero the Lord is still alive. Pero wala na yatang minion wave doon sa ibaba. Pero mukhang babasag yata. Look at H2O. Just targeting pero nawala doon.
Nawala.
Yung catapult. And
still,
what a perfect defense.
Nadepensa nila yun.
Oo. Timing lane. Ang ganda rin kasi ng mga minion wave clear ng execration. Still, the middle lane can be taken down. And yun na, inulti na. Nag-last insanity na doon si Zapno. Just to be able to clear down the wave. And QT, tumalon doon si Yawi. Dinikit sila lahat doon sa may tore. But the Fatal Links will hit on too. But the Deathless of Blade will be there. It will be enough nga kaya but H2O mapapatay ni Zapdo. Chester going in para sa atas, medyo unti-unti naubos yan dito ang NXP Solid. Eto Max having a triple kill and as well with hate na buhay pa rin, unang patay niya yon pero as a shutdown and a wipe out dito, sabi nila dito takbo na mga to,
takbo, pinapatakbo sila ngayon ng execution yung boss nila for sure. Takbo kayo sa mid lane, go for it and take it out as much as you can.
Kaya ba this is 20 seconds on the death timer dito ng NXP Solid. Mukhang
oh
kaya
my
to.
God kaya
to, tingin ko kaya to, kaya to, hold nila to, medyo tinatangkin nila dito,
tatangkin nila yan for sure.
Dako po mga kaibigan, that's gonna
be base,
dako po yung base, yung base,
hold
nila dito. Execration taking number 3.
Oh my god, what? What?
What is happening? What is happening?
Ano nangyari? Ano yun?
Ano yun?
Si Billy, hindi naman. Uy, nahulog.
Speechless talaga kami mga kaibigan. Isipin mo yun. Isang beses lang nakapatay si Hate sa laro na yun. Yung pa yung pinakamahalagang napatay niya. Oh my God. Wow. Look at Zabnu. He's actually crying. This is the tears of joy.
Paano? Paano?